So the next point that we're going to look at in our titration curve is, what is the pH at the endpoint? And at the endpoint, our moles of H plus are going to equal our moles of OH minus. And for this particular case, and whenever we look at the pH of the endpoint, the pH is going to be dictated by the pH of the salt. In a strong acid, strong base titration, everything's going to be neutral, and it's a fairly straightforward calculation. But here, we don't have a neutral salt, because the pH of this salt is going to be dictated by the fact that sodium hydroxide is a strong base. That means it's going to have a weaker conjugate acid. So the acetic acid, weak acid, means that the salt formed from the acetate ion is going to be on the basic side. So we would expect this pH to be basic. Okay, so let's kind of dive into the calculations that we would see here. So initially, we have 2.5 millimoles of acetic acid. We need to add an equal amount of base. So we're going to have 2.5 millimoles of this base added. So that means our neutralization reaction is going to be, we're going to be neutralizing 2.5 millimoles of our acid and 2.5 millimoles of our base. That means at our end point here and at the end of the neutralization, we have 0 moles of both acetic acid and sodium hydroxide. But in the process, 2.5 millimoles of our salt were formed in this neutralization. So we have 2.5 millimoles of acetic acid at the endpoint of our titration. So if we have 2.5 millimoles of NaC2H3O2 divided by, and in this case we have to add 25 milliliters of each to reach this endpoint, so we're going to have 50.00 milliliters. That gives us a concentration of 0.05 molar for our NaC2H3O2. So if we look at our salt, so we have NaC2H3O2, and this is going to break down into Na plus ions in solution plus C2H3O2 minus ions in solution. And if we have 0.05 molar sodium acetate, that means we have 0.05 molar sodium plus ions and 0.05 molar acetate ions. We don't really care about the Na plus, because this is going to be neutral, because it's the conjugate acid of NaOH, which is a strong base. Okay, but if we look at the acetate ion, it comes from a weak acid. That means this salt is going to be basic. So this is very, very important. So we have to take this particular salt into consideration. So we have C2H3O2 plus water. It's going to be in equilibrium with HC2H3O2 aqueous plus OH minus ions. We can set up an ice table from here, starting with 0.05 molar acetate ion, which is what we have. The water is a pure liquid, so it won't show up in our equilibrium expression. And our concentration initially of acetic acid and OH minus ion is going to be 0. As this equilibrium establishes itself, the change in concentration is going to be minus X for the acetate ion, plus X for the acetic acid, and plus X for the OH minus. That gives us 0.05 minus X, X, and X for our equilibrium concentrations. Now here, our Ka for our acetic acid expression is 1.8 times 10 to the minus 5. So remember that the Ka times the Kb is going to equal 1 times 10 to the minus 14. So our Kb expression, when we approximate here, we can say x squared divided by 0.05 minus x is going to equal the Kw divided by the Ka, which is 1 times 10 to the minus 14 divided by 1.8 times 10 to the minus 5. If we go through here and we do the math, our x is going to be equal to 5.3 times 10 to the minus 6, which if we look up here, our x is going to be the concentration of OH minus ions at equilibrium. So our pOH is going to equal 5.28, and the pH is going to equal 14 minus that, which is equal to 8.72. And this agrees with what we said from the onset, that this pH is going to be basic due to the fact that our salt, sodium acetate, is going to be the conjugate base of a weak acid. And since it's a conjugate base, the pH should be greater than 7, which is in agreement with the value of 8.72 that we calculated here.